Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, welcome. My name is Alex, and I mainly do lifestyle, beauty, and vlog type of videos, but today's video is a little bit different. So I recently took the 23andMe Health and Ancestry genetic test, and I thought I would share my results with you guys. So when it comes to my ethnicity, I get a few different guesses from people, and if this is your first time seeing me, let me know what your guess is. But the most common ones I get are that I am A, white, B, Hispanic, or C, Greek. Those are the most common assumptions I get. So when it comes to my parents, my mom is 100% Mexican. She was born and raised in Mexico. And my dad is a white American. And before taking this test, I really knew nothing about either side of my parents' ancestry. The only thing I knew for certain was that my grandma, so my dad's mom, her maiden name is Müller, which is German, and I know that she mentioned that her great-great-grandfather was a German doctor, so I was expecting to see some German in there, and sure enough, that did appear, but everything else was a total surprise. So I'm excited to show you guys my results, and let's just get into it. Okay, I have my computer here in front of me looking at my results, and I'm going to throw up screenshots of everything. So I'm going to show you my map first, and when I first saw it, I was shocked at how colorful it was. Okay, I'll show you guys my biggest percentage, which was European, and that was 83.9%, with 48.5% of that being Northwestern European, which is 100% my dad's half. 28.8% of that is British and Irish, but if you click into it, it looks like it's all from the United Kingdom. And looking more into it, it looks like in the last 200 years, I had ancestors that lived there, predominantly in the Greater London area, but they show 10 other regions as well. So I was definitely surprised at how prevalent my British ancestry was, and that I probably had a great-great-grandparent that was 100% British, and that was something I had no idea about and that I want to look into further. Next is French and German, and that is 13.3%. And clicking into it, it looks like that percentage is just German. And I actually got a specific region in Germany, and I believe it's called Hesse. So that confirms my assumption that I have German ancestry from my paternal grandmother's side, and I think that's so cool, and I can't wait to share that with my grandma. And then I have 6.4% of broadly Northwestern European, which they say are represented by people as far west as Ireland, as far north as Norway, as far east as Finland, and as far south as France. And then it matches several specific populations and cannot be assigned to just one. This shared heritage may be the result of extensive migration, possibly including the Germanic invasions of the early Middle Ages. So I think that concludes my dad's half of my ancestry. What surprised me the most is that I don't seem to have any Irish and no Scandinavian or Finnish either. It seems to be predominantly British and German, and those ancestors seem to be the most recent as well. But there is that 6.4% that they can't seem to exactly pinpoint, so maybe I do have some Irish and Scandinavian me, it's just not very strong. Okay, so moving on to my mom's half. So it says that I am 30.8% Southern European, with 23.3% being Spanish and Portuguese. But they weren't able to detect a specific region of where my ancestors might have lived. But it is something that they will update as they get more information, so that's pretty cool anyways. And then I have 7.5% broadly Southern European, which they say includes the Iberian, Italian, and Balkan peninsulas, as well as the island of Malta, and is a region defined in great part by the Mediterranean Sea. Broadly Southern European DNA matches several specific populations and is difficult to assign to just one. So similar to my 6.4% of broadly Northwestern European, it's hard to narrow down. I should also say that I have 0% Greek, Italian, and Eastern European, which is interesting. And then I have 0.6% of Ashkenazi Jewish, which was so surprising. And then 4% broadly European, which they say that some European DNA is difficult to assign confidently to one population and receives a broadly designation. So if I were to combine all my broadly European percentages together, I would get 17.9% of my European ancestry that is hard to pinpoint, which I think is a pretty big percentage, because if I subtract that from my overall European percentage, that leaves me with only 66% of my European ancestry really defined. So hopefully with time and more people doing these tests, I'll be able to see more specifically where my ancestry is from. Okay, moving on to the next big percentage in my ancestry, and that is that I am 8.8% East Asian and Native American, with 7.9% being Native American and 0.9% being broadly East Asian and Native American. So looking more into it, I discovered that my ancestors were part of the first people to reach North America. And that's confirmed with my maternal haplogroup, which shows the migration of my maternal line. So my ancestors crossed Beringia, which was a land bridge that connected Siberia to Alaska, and then migrated south and became the first Americans. So I thought that was so cool and amazing to learn, because I had no idea. And looking more deeply into the percentages of East Asian and Native American, I have 0% in Chinese and Southeast Asia, Japanese and Korean, and Northern Asia, so no ancestry at all there. But I have 0.9% broadly East Asian and Native American, and it says that the ancestors of Native Americans began to cross into the Americas 12 to 15,000 years ago. Broadly East Asian and Native American DNA is a relic of this ancient population split and reflects shared roots in Central and Northern Asia. So overall, that was pretty amazing to learn that I have Native American ancestry and that my ancestors were the first people to come to America. So I was really excited to learn about that. Okay, moving on to some of the smaller percentages, I learned that I am 1.7% sub-Saharan African, with 0.9% being Angolan and Congolese, and 0.5% West African, with 0.3% being Nigerian and 0.2% Senegambian and Guinean, and then 0.3% broadly sub-Saharan African. And again, that broadly is because it is difficult to assign some DNA to specific populations within sub-Saharan Africa, and I am 0% Northern East African. And then I am 1.2% broadly Western Asian and North African, and they weren't able to pinpoint any specifics within that group at all, just saying that the peoples of Western Asia and North Africa have deep linguistic and genetic connections with one another, dating back to some of the earliest migrations out of Africa. So again, hopefully with some time I can get more specific information, but yeah, combined I have 2.9% African ancestry, which is something I had no idea about, but that is something that was so cool and amazing to learn. And then I have 0.1% of trace ancestry from broadly Central and South Asia, so very tiny percentage, but it's there. And then I have 4.3% unassigned. So that completes the percentage portion of my ancestry, but we're not done. So they actually detected that I have recent ancestry in the Americas, specifically in Mexico, and they say that in the last 200 years, your ancestors may have lived in the following locations. And I'm like, yeah, my mom. But they gave a list of the top 10 regions, with the first one being Sonora, which is where my mom was born and raised. So they nailed it. And they give more information about how Mexico and Central America are very mixed, and it says that 23andMe customers from Mexico and Central America typically have evidence of Native American, Southern European, and West African ancestry in their DNA, though the breakdown varies throughout the region. Native American ancestry typically reaches high levels in Mexico, El Salvador, and Guatemala, while West African ancestry is more common in Belize. And that African ancestry is found throughout the region as well, ranging from an average of 2% in Mexico to over 40% in Belize. Historical records indicate that hundreds of thousands of enslaved African people disembarked in Central America between 1520 and 1820, many of whom were sent to the silver mines of northern Mexico or to logging operations in Belize. Today, most 23andMe customers with grandparents from Mexico and Central America have at least 1% African DNA, reflecting admixture that occurred many generations ago. I find it interesting that it says that the average African ancestry for Mexicans is 2%, but I have pretty much 3% and I'm half Mexican. There is an ancestry timeline that gives an estimate for how many generations ago was your most recent ancestor for each population. And when it comes to my African ancestors, they predict that they were born between 1720 and 1840. So that's really interesting. So I showed my parents my results and they were just as surprised as I was, and they were really interested in it too. My mom actually wants to take the test and learn more about her ancestry, so I think that's pretty cool. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it interesting, and if you did, don't forget to give it a like and subscribe to see more content from me. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye everyone!